Hey everybody, I wanted to show something that I've been working on for a little while now, and it's how to integrate Tailwind with dotnet. So there's many ways that I've seen from YouTube and just various sources, and all of them are not ideal in my opinion, and I'm going to explain why. So if you go to Tailwind's documentation and look, they do have a framework guides section. And if you look in the list here, dotnet is not one of them. So at the bottom, they do provide a way, like if you don't see your framework of choice, go to the Tailwind CLI, and you can look in this example and see that, okay, well, they have an npm CLI that I could run via npx, but I don't want to do that, right? Like my .NET projects don't use npm, as 99% of them probably don't use npm. So Tailwind again does provide a way to accomplish it. So this link here at the top, it says if you don't want to use Node.js, then you can use a standalone executable. So this is a blog post from Adam Wathen back in 2021 that essentially announced a way that Tailwind now has to run Tailwind without having Node.js installed on your machine. So this is a standalone executable. You can see that it's downloaded from GitHub. And you can actually just run it as you would any other program on your computer, right? You provided your input style sheet and your output style sheet, and that's that, right? But when you want to use something like this with .NET, you have to think about, okay, well, where do I put this in my code, right? Do I download it once and just throw it in my repository as a file? And then, okay, well, now when do I execute that script, right? Do I have to make the developers do it manually? Like that feels weird, right? I don't want to have to do even think about it. I want the framework to handle it automatically for me. So what I'm showing here is sort of solving all of these problems. So what I'm looking at now is this .NET project. This is an empty Blazor project. There's nothing to it. There's no customizations except for one thing, and I created a styles folder with a main CSS file that imports Tailwind CSS. So now I'm going to plop in a file into this project directory, and it's right here, this tailwind.targets file. I'm not going to show you what it is yet, but I'm going to import it into my CS project. So I'm just doing that now. And I'm also going to set a few parameters at the top of here. So I'm going to set tailwind version to just the word latest. And I'm also going to specify my input style sheet path, which was, if you remember, styles main CSS right here. That was my input file. And I'm also going to specify my output path. So my output style sheet path is going to be just this one here. I'm going to say www root main CSS. And with only that, I'm now going to hit build. And we can look at the console output here and see that Tailwind actually did do its thing, right? We are now referencing this Tailwind Linux 64. I'm running WSL, so this is the correct executable. And it ran against my input style sheet with my output style sheet. So in the directory here, in my product directory, you can now see that the main CSS file was created for me. So that's all I had to do was import this single file and provide a few inputs. And that's that. Tailwind is now integrated with .NET. Well, if you're interested in sort of how this works, let's go and dig into the Tailwind targets file. So this file is essentially tapping into the compilation of .NET. So there's a target here called Tailwind that runs before the build target. So this is a standard .NET thing where when I hit the build solution or run .NET build, it will actually execute this target behind the scenes. And Microsoft, being the great company they are, actually provide a way to tap into that process. So this target here actually will run the Tailwind CLI. But before that actually happens, it needs to actually pull the CLI from somewhere, right? So of course, it will depend on another one. So this Tailwind CLI one is at the top. And you can see that it does a little bit of fancy footwork regarding the C sharp scripts, where it's checking my architecture and my OS and determining which CLI to actually download, right? Because it is architecture and OS specific. So this script will do everything for you, and you don't really need to change anything into this file except just put it into your code base. And there's quite a few parameters that you can override different things. For example, if you wanted to change your version, I could download a different version by just saying, by just changing the version here and running build again. Again, didn't do anything else, but changes just changed that one thing. And now you can see it's actually downloading it from GitHub and putting it into this directory on my computer. That's it. So if you have comments or questions, I would love to hear them. So feel free to leave a comment, hit the like button. Would love to hear from you.